and welcome to Bolingbrook Prison. It is looking to be another very sunny San Andreas day. We are on the border with the desert, so things can get pretty hot here. And we are out for a patrol with the San Andreas Prison Service. We're going to be taking the prison service van. So you'll notice that has police on the back. Basically, the ped pack that I have installed actually overwrites these guys. So yeah, they've kind of got police in the back. So may as well have it that the prison service are going to be a kind of private police force dedicated to defending the prison system. Anyway, we're right on shift, so I think it would be prudent to start the shift with a perimeter patrol of the prison of which we are defending. So today I am Constable Bill Talbert of the Prison Service of San Andreas. And today we're driving the van. This is the Mercedes Sprinter Prisoner Transport. Whoa.
Attention Unit 1, Lincoln 18. We have a stolen police vehicle.
No. Grand Sonora Desert.
Okay, I can't see them. So the problem, as a private police force, we do have
Ocean 1 responding.
A very small amount of over the border jurisdiction. Or rather over the fence jurisdiction. So what that is in the UK, I don't know how it works everywhere, there are a number of private police services, such as the Port of Dover Police, number of private fire services like power station.
No, go away.
We've got local officers needing assistance
in
Grand Sonora Desert.
Power station fire services and things, and basically they have a very limited ability to if this was a prison and there was an emergency, over where that fence is, we could respond to that because it's just over the fence from where we are. It's about getting the quickest reaction rather than the right people, as it were. So, we do kind of have that going for us, but hopefully that won't come up. And certainly I'm not going as far as to chase a police car in a van when I'm part of the prison service. That doesn't quite work. While we're kind of mucking around a little bit, I want to show you the cool part about this vehicle. So this is a Mercedes Sprinter by Team MOH, and if I left rear, there we are. Yes. Oh, look at the inside of that. If we just take a little pop out. So yeah, this is the inside of the prison transport van. You've basically got cell space for four, maybe five prisoners. Two individuals and two or three in the back. It's pretty cool. I quite like the blue lights as well in the interior. This is a relatively old mod now, so it's actually not ELS capable, but I have given it an ELS profile, which I should probably put on. Just I've only got an ELS profile so I can use the button, otherwise I've got to press wacky buttons to get it going. Anyway, we've been on duty for a while now and nothing's happened, so let's just take a little check inside the prison itself, making sure that out is kicking off. New inmate. There's more prison service.
Attention all units.
We've got a civilian in need of assistance.
On junction 12 on the M5.
Okay. That one we will go to. It's just, I know the road, it's within, it's within the over the fence jurisdiction, so we'll head out to that. It did say code 2, code 3 is the response that we use if it's Nino. I don't know why I did that, thank God. I don't think I've recorded a single normal video since I got back to YouTube. Anyway, so we're going to head on down. I don't know what we're going to get. So I do just need to make sure that car gets past safely. Right, okay, so let's try and spot this person. So far I can't see them. can't fact see anything.
Dispatch, we have a visual.
1 out of 12.
You do? What's the damn visual? We'll keep our blue lights on just to keep everybody right and safe. But I'm not seeing what we're supposed to be looking for. At the moment, this would count as suspicious activity around about the prison, so I think we are perfectly well justified in attending this call and doing it. I'm wondering if there may be someone hiding or otherwise in the grass. Okay, let's just, we'll get on out and maybe have a little foot search in some of the more grassy areas. I don't really know what we're gonna see. Something blipped. I don't know if it's blipping my vehicle or if it's blipping something else. Anyway, there's nobody up top, and I can't see anyone in the foliage. There was, the blip's gone. We'll just take a check back. I don't know. I don't. The blip could very well be my van. That's currently what I'm thinking. But yeah, it must be. There's no sign of a people. Careful about crossing live highway here. Let me just get across. And just have a check of the foliage on this side, make sure nobody's lurking around, or worse, could be injured. Could be looking for a backpacker who's maybe taking a tumble down the hillside or something. But if the depth of field will kick in. Yeah. Yeah, no, I can't see anyone here, so maybe if we just do I need to make sure it's safe to cross. Okay, peg it. Right, I think it's quite safe to say that there's absolutely nothing going on, so let's just do Control F9 and end the current call out. That's fine. So, yeah, well, we found nothing. We found absolutely nothing. So, not else to do but to head back over to the prison. Sorry, buddy, sorry. We weren't trying to pull you over. Come on, go. Oh, yeah, right, I forget it does that. okay, so we'll head back up. So, we'll not take the path which we came down. I keep pointing, because I know I've got the camera on me. I always forget that the camera can't actually, like, see what I'm pointing at. You just kind of have to infer it by the fact that I'm pointing and pointing at something. Yeah. Maybe I should have, like, a virtual reality setup where it's like I've got a 360-degree camera next to me. God, that would be pretty interesting, actually. But no, I'm not going to do it. Oh.
Attention Unit 1, Lincoln 18.
We have
a petty theft.
Sandy Shores.
That is a firm no. Okay, so.
Roger, dispatch, we are en route.
Okay, so we're heading back to the prison. So while we've kind of got some quiet time, I'm going to confess something to you. I actually tried recording this video before, and it all went absolutely tits up.
Attention Unit 1, Lincoln 18.
We've got officers in need of assistance. Grant Sonora Desert.
Yeah, fine. We will go to that once again over the fence policy, and it is asking for backup.
Moving right now.
Copy. All received.
What was I saying? Yes. So I tried to record it, and I actually got killed because on vanilla LSPDFR you can't actually go into the. Oh, shots fired! Shit, son.
Grand Sonora Desert. Please go stage 5 en route.
Backup.
Armed officers respond. More officers needed in Grand Sonora Desert.
Right, well, we're.
Please respond urgently.
Acknowledge. We've got more police arriving. We're a private we're private security, so we don't really have much in the way of firepower. However, I am quite tempted to overrule that, seeing as we do have officers down. We'll take a... Jesus, fuck! He's got a freaking assault rifle, Jesus. There's a boat! There's a boat! Somebody get the damn boat off me. Jesus, fuck. Right, okay. Great! Excellent. However, it is quite also true that we have a number of officers down. So let's just get EMS by the
officers requesting paramedics in Grand Sonora Desert. Please respond urgently.
By the truckload. Anyway, we've got one suspect down, one officer down.
You're a waste of space.
Looks like ARV from Transport Police is assisting us here. And the Grand Commander is the officer in the officer's cap. Here comes paramedics. Good stuff. Jeez. What an emergency scene this turned out to be. Okay, so who's got what?
Get over yourself.
Right, so... policeman's fatal'd.
This is crazy.
And the suspect is not. So let's just go ahead and get that out. Oi, 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 sunshine, sunshine, stop, stop.
One move and I drop.
Oh my lord!
I hate this game. I really didn't want to do it at first, but I'm now going to have to get the mod that stops people freaking out.
We have on junction 12 on the M5.
Right, let's just start tasing the fuck out of people. Right, I want this guy. Right. Okay. You!
Time for your beatdown.
God's sake. Right, you. Yeah.
More officers needed.
Why the hell is he still going? He's been shot at.
Junction 12 on the M5.
Right, let's just get everybody detained here.
Copter, thanks.
I don't know who's shooting. Right, get down. Right, okay. Right, he's under arrest for murder. You're under arrest for assault on a police officer.
Assistance required.
You are under arrest for interfering with a police officer in the course of his duty. Now, I originally said that we weren't chasing after people. In a police van. However, we've had a police car stolen from the prison. So it's going to be quite prudent that we try and do what we can to catch it.
You fucker.
And as a result... Yeah. Right, okay, so everyone's getting picked up. So we're going to head back to the van. And we're going to arm ourselves up for the hunt for this. I don't know how... Yeah, okay, so this will get us armor and things. Okay, so we've got our bulletproof vest, and we're going to have to enact our armed authorization by getting us a weapon, which I now need to find. Oh, is it on this side? Here we go. Right, so carbine rifle is kind of what the popo usually have. So here we go. We've got our armed authorization, and now we've got to go find us a police car. I suppose we shouldn't be using spike strips at all, because we're not traffic. We won't have spike strips on this thing. But yes, I wasn't all too sure about whether this force should be armed or not, but in retrospect, having a lot of the potential for prisoner rioting. Yeah, I think they should have access to guns. I think that's only fair in the grand scheme of things. Anyway, we've got to try and catch up with this police vehicle. I'm straight away going to go ahead and get us... Crap, I don't have the pursuit interface on yet. Right, let's just... for God's sake.
We've got a resisting custody in Grand Sonora Desert.
Oh, crap, Andy's shooting at us. Well, we're in an armored vehicle, which is a sport.
Attention all units. We have officers requesting an eye in the sky. Engine 99, over. Grand Sonora Desert.
Yeah, okay, right. Control. This is... Bravo Papa 07 requesting local ARV units to take over.
Stand to. We have officers in need of assistance in Grand Sonora Desert.
I think they're coming towards us. This is a bad place to kind of be. Crap, is he just shot on my tire? Guys, take over, take over. Oh no, we've got a roadblock ahead, so yeah. So it wasn't a prison vehicle, thankfully, it was just a local vehicle. However, we're gonna go on out. Oh, fuck. Ah, they got three, so back to the van. Right, let's move! Okay. We've got slight damage to our vehicle, and damage to me. We can hear it. Okay, I think this is now getting out of my jurisdiction. So I know they've got local officers on it, and there they're going past. So I'm going to discontinue the pursuit at my end. And we're going to head back to the prison to the mechanics. Now this is the kind of the point where I would say that we would switch to an undamaged vehicle, but actually I don't have another kind of prison service vehicle, so I guess we'll just have to stay in the van. Alright, so we'll head back to the prison. What time is it? Oh, it's nearly 5 o'clock, so only a few more hours until Clowkin Alf. We'll head here. So, the mechanic will come get a look at this. In fact, we should probably put it into the bay. Okay, so we'll get this. We'll get our vehicle looked at. And we will head out. So we're no longer in a situation where we've got organized criminals, so we lose our armed authorization. And, well, I think what we'll do is we'll get another prison bus. So, they've got us this one. So, I guess while again we've now got some more time to kill, I'll show you the liveries, because I appreciate we'll never actually have seen the prison service before. So I wasn't all too sure how I was going to handle it. And basically I decided, based on the UK, a lot of prison transports have their markings on the side, but some don't as well. So I've included a kind of range of things. So we've got the fully marked version, which has got the kind of half Battenberg on the side and prison service on the front. There is the black stripe version, which is literally just prison service on the side, prison service on the front, and then a wee black stripe. And then there's basically the unmarked edition, which only has the prison service logo on the side and front. I decided a fully unmarked vehicle would not be allowed because it's a private company. Well, it's not a private company, it's a private police force, so it would be more prudent for it to be If it has blue lights, it should be in some form marked. And so it is. So, let's just, I guess, go and finish off the rest of our patrol in the prison. We've had quite a lot of excitement. We've had officers down, one under arrest for murder, one under arrest for assault on police, one under arrest for interference, and then a pursuit with some organized criminals. Great, who stole police cars. But hopefully the Blaine County Police will get them strapped. Well, transport police were there as well, so yeah, hopefully they'll manage to do that. Anyway, it's going to be about dinner time in the prison, so I wouldn't necessarily expect there to be too much in the way of stuff. I might get called into a food fight, and the other officers are on patrol. Yeah, so as the sun sets in the Grand Sonora Desert, things are looking not unreasonable in the prison. Things are fine on this side. And then we're back to the main area. So I'm sure there are internal areas here, but I'm not going to dive into them. It's now 6:30, so 90 minutes left on the shift. Crap, please don't know. Oh, crap, dink the wall. Oh no, it's a dead end. I thought this was like an underpass. Whoops. Alright, reverse again. I'm getting good mileage out of my reverse gear in this patrol. Okay. And for all the excitement that happened in the middle, it looks like it's going to be quite a quiet end to the shift itself. We're not in duty in the prison grounds, so there's not really any reason to dive into the prison actual. I guess what we could do is we could help out our colleagues in the NCA and make sure everyone, because we're going to be getting into visitation hours, so we might do some cheeky intelligence gathering, make sure everybody who has arrived to speak to prisoners is there to just speak to prisoners and isn't doing anything else that might be untoward. So what we'll do, we'll go into here. More police turning up. I wonder if that's our stolen vehicle. Stolen police vehicle. Anyway, what I'll do is I'll actually mount that curb. So we'll keep the van in a ready position in case it's needed, and we'll just check the plates on all of the visitors. So what I'm looking for is this one. So we've got here YK17HZE. Let's just make sure everyone's alright. All legit, noise, no trace on PNC. Hopefully everyone is legit. I would rather that they were. KCE. Seeing as there's not much else to do, we may see if we can find any trouble. Wait. Why is everyone owned by Cletus Ray? I wonder if that's just because it's not actually involved in a crime, it's not assigned anybody a name. So we've got XE15HMG. Oh crap. Okay, alright, we screwed up. XE15HMG. Oop! Cletus Ray. Yeah, okay, right, so this doesn't work too well because there's no there's no kind of scene going on, I guess. So I don't think it's generating the information as needed. So I guess we can take one more patrol around the penitentiary. Oh, what's an ambulance doing? It's a bit of an odd location for an ambulance. We'll just we'll take a little follow of them, because just because they're on ambulance doesn't mean they're not really up to stuff. They're going fast, but they're not on blue lights, and they're on my property. I don't necessarily know if they have a patient on board. Oh, they're slowing down a lot. They were doing about 50 miles an hour before. Now they're picking back up. I don't know, something's not sitting right with this. Well, they're not on a blue light job, and neither are we. Let's, let's just go in there and shit. Well, they are ambulance staff, and I can't pull them over. So this isn't like GTA 4 where you can pull them over, so I guess we'll just let them do whatever they're doing. Not much is happening, so I guess as one last thing before clocking off, we'll just take a little double check on the roads leading into the prison, make sure nobody is blocking roads, nobody's doing anything untowards. So we'll just go ahead and do that. And then I guess that'll be the end of the patrol. So exciting start. Petered out a bit, but yeah. Sometimes that is life in the wonderful world of LSPDFR. Yeah, okay, he's doing one turn stuff. Who's this? Ow.
Oh shit! I ain't never gonna live this down!
We'll look at that. I don't think these people want to stop. Oh, wait, there's a helicopter shooting at them. Alright, I don't know what we've come across here, but it's going onto the motorway, so... Oh no, they're out. Oh god, they've got guns! Local units.
All SFOs, show stand to. Our assistance needed on Junction 7 on the M6 in Grand Sonora Desert.
Jesus. I don't think the police officers are still alive. We'll kind of keep watching until backup arrives. I think at least one unit's behind us, but we'll wait for them to take control of the scene. Oh, so that's the police ahead of us. And over the bodies. Alright, okay. Fine. Where's the police officer? Did they escape? I think they must have jumped onto the motorway to escape. Alright, well, we've got another pretty nasty scene to deal with here. We've got at least the ambulance on scene. Oi. Looks like the ground commanders are starting to arrive on scene. So, alright, well, a busy shift to... Well, a busy incident to end the shift. I wasn't quite expecting in a prison patrol to have to use the gun so much. In fact, I don't think we had a single call where technically having the gun handed out was not justified. Oh well, it is what it is. The shift is now over an hour and a half ago. We'll leave the scene in the careful hands of local officers. I guess they'll have to come take statements from me because the firearms were deployed. And they can do so at the comfort of my prison. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for watching this episode, the very first episode of On Patrol with the San Andreas Prison Service. So far, we have seen 0 prisoners and 3 shootouts. But such is the wonderful world of GTA. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.